Oh no. There's nothing to feel sorry about. I'm really happy to help you out with this practice date. I mean, that's all it was, right?
You don't get it, do you? You crack me up. You are so stupid. Duh. That's as cold as the pond water at the farm. Well, good thing you're here. If hypothermia sets in, will you warm me up like you did the last time? The skin-to-skin contact really helped.
You want skin-to-skin? How about I put my fist in your face?
Detective Cutter was killed by a guy named Brent Lawrence, and what's more, he was disguised as a woman. What do you think? We play the transvestite angle to the hilt. Wait, it gets better. It seems Spaulding fired this guy, Lawrence, as a man, and then rehired him as a woman. Apparently nobody at the office could tell the difference. If I say this source is clean, it's impeccable. That's why I own the station and you don't. I got one more source to tap into and we're on the air, okay? With any luck, we're gonna get a 25 share, maybe 30. I mean, this is the biggest story to hit Springfield in generations. It is a WSBR exclusive, so get on it.
What story would that be?
Quiet. What was that? Make a sound and it's your last.
Mom, we can't see the view from here. Are you coming or not?
I guess so.
Wait, don't tell me you're scared. What, are you afraid of ghosts or something like that?
Help! Somebody help me!
Abigail, it's all right. No, don't feel foolish. The kiss was just part of the practice date. What? No. Abby, no. This was my idea, okay? Role-playing, it always gets me into trouble, you know, because I'm a ham and I go too far and I try to be funny all the time. Let me explain, all right? You should have seen my sister when I was teaching her how to dance. I almost broke her leg. Why? Because I was trying to be funny. Abby, you did good. You did really good. And when you start to date, you're gonna be fine. Because you're a good person. And you have a wonderful heart. Just be yourself. Mistake? What mistake? Abigail, you didn't make a mistake. Way to go, Rick. Way to go.
Refreshing.
Yes, thank you very much. And may I add, richly deserved.
Yeah, well, you got that right.
You know what? You woke me up enough to know that I have no business meddling in your life, and I promise from now on I'm gonna keep my mouth shut.
Yeah, I think you'd have to gargle cement.
I'm serious. Okay, the only reason I've been giving you a hard time about Roger is because I've been down that road before. I didn't like it then, and I don't like it now.
Well, I do.
Yeah, no one wanted my father to be a good guy more than me. And no one was more disappointed to find out who he really was than me.
Who he really is a wonderful human being.
He's a liar, Dinah. He's a liar who divides to conquer, alienates for his own advantage. OK? Okay, he gets what he wants, while the people that he supposedly cares about gets nothing.
Well, that's your point of view.
Call me crazy, but I didn't want you to live through the letdown, too.
Why do you care?
Because you're so bright. You're so incredibly full of life. I didn't want to see my father strip all that away from you.
Well, stop worrying about me and worry about yourself. I mean, talk about beating a grudge to death.
He stole everything that my grandfather had. That's what probably killed the old
man. He's tried to make that up to you over and over again.
Well, he can stop trying because it ain't gonna work.
You know, a few days ago, for about 5 minutes, you really had me going.
Going where?
You had me convinced that you were a decent person.
To know me is to love me.
It was only 5 minutes. And your true colors came through again.
I look good in black.
You know, when you heard the bull that Holly and Fletcher were spouting about Roger, you just jumped all over it, didn't you?
It wasn't bull.
You cannot even give your own father the benefit of the doubt.
Just keep it up. Just keep it up. Keep on believing in a man who sent your best friend up the creek without a paddle. You know, I'm not like him, okay? So you can always count on me. Always. Whenever, whatever you need, give me a call.
Marcus, hi. I have great news, and I'm at the tower, so come over here and meet me right away. No, I can't tell you over the phone. Because I want to see your handsome face when you hear this news. Okay, I'll give you a hint. This great news is courtesy of Dinah and Roger Thorpe. No, that's it. That's it. That's all I'm telling you. Now get over here right away. Okay, I'll see you soon.
Hey.
How are you?
Good.
Yeah. I'm glad you said yes to that dinner date.
Well, so am I.
I've been spending way too much time in the hotel room. I've memorized the entire room service menu. The chicken, the fish, the pizzas, the hamburgers. This is more what I had in mind.
Mm-hmm. Actually, you know what? I can recommend the blackened swordfish. It is excellent.
You know, I saw Marcus today. He looks a whole lot better not wearing that orange jumpsuit.
Yes. Bail is great, and freedom from all those charges is going to be even greater.
Yeah, I'm telling you, it's hard not to be able to tell the whole world about this, the police finding this new suspect.
Have patience. Soon you'll be able to, what, shout it from a rooftop.
This scampi looks interesting.
You can cut the game out now, Griffin.
I beg your pardon?
You didn't invite me to dinner for the food or to get your mind off Marcus's case.
You think you know me pretty well now, huh?
Well, well enough to know that you never do
anything
without
a reason.
Yes.
The truth is that Marcus is soon to be exonerated on that murder charge. But this stealing money out of the cash register, that charge is still pending.
Not if someone can connect Roger Thorpe to that phone call that set Marcus up.
Exactly. I need to know every little bit of information there is to know on this Thorpe character.
Hey, the paper press.
What is the biggest story to hit Springfield?
Since when does WSPR share its scoops with the Journal?
You're playing at being a reporter now, Roger?
How hard can it be? You do it. So what smoldering story are you attempting to fan into flames?
No, tell us yours first.
Now, I hope you're not still working on this ridiculous theory that I was responsible for setting up Marcus Williams, because libel suits don't come cheap these days.
Stick a summons in it.
You gotta be kidding me. Say that again?
We drew a blank on those grocery stores.
Nobody in all of those stores saw this guy. No cashiers, managers, nobody.
Maybe.
This guy's gotta eat, you know that?
I don't know, Frank. Maybe he'd already had enough supplies stocked up.
I don't want to hear that. This guy's gotta go out sometime.
Sooner or later?
Yeah, well, you know what? The sooner the better.
Look, I'm gonna go down to the lab. Do you want anything?
No, thanks.
Well, hey, gotta go. Lots to do. Night, all.
Oh!
No, please, I insist. I have to tell you, I consider you a credit to the force. And, I am fully appreciative of your cooperative spirit. So, please, after you, officer.
Thank you.
What do you think he's up to?
Frank, You got a minute?
Listen, I didn't forget. We're waiting on the lab right now.
All right, the tape for the robbery tip.
Yeah, so trying to enhance the voice.
Any word from Lucy?
No.
Any contact from Brent Lawrence?
As of an hour ago, he contacted Al Michael.
What, over the telephone?
Via the computer in his office.
And?
And as of an hour ago, my sister was still alive.
That was nice.
Yeah, well, I know nice. And that was nicer than nice. Again?
Wait, stop. Hey, stop. What are you doing?
Easy,
right? I'm not like that. Why'd you just do that?
Well, I thought you wanted to, all right? Why'd you bring me to the beach?
I brought you here because I wanted to show you around. I thought we could be friends, you know, friends. I don't want to fight about it, all right?
Hey, look, you know, fine with me, all right? I never forced myself on a woman a day in my life, and I never will, all right? I should have known you weren't ready for this.
It's just too fast.
Yeah, well, okay. We can see each other around school or something like that, right? Say hi. You know, you're a nice kid.
I'm not a kid.
Hey, 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 take it easy, all right? I was trying to be the good guy here or something. Come back here, Michelle.
You're all the same, every last one of you. Lying, teasing sluts. You deserve to die. No. No, Brent, no. See what you almost made me do? Too easy. It's much too easy. When you die, you stop suffering, and I don't want you to do that. You and your pretty boyfriend are gonna suffer the same way I had to suffer. And to do that, I can't stray from my plan. Don't you think that's a better idea than, say, sawing your head off? What? Nothing to say? Say something.
Who was that?
Oh, just a little bimbo and her poor boyfriend playing the eternal game. She lured him here with false promises, just the way you did when we had our big date. She came on to him until he went with it, and then she cried, "No way!" Sound familiar?
Don't tell me you killed him.
No, but I should have. I could have saved him the misery of trying again. The whole thing made me sick.
Look, why don't you just leave? You're not making things any easier.
Amanda, my place is here with Alan.
I'll keep you informed. I promise. Just please go.
Son, I realize why you hate me. But we have to put our family differences aside right now. The most important thing is to rescue Lucy. Now let me help you make this right. Is Brent communicating via computer?
Yeah. When he feels like it.
Son, I know the top computer man in this country.
Thank you very much. Our computer people are working just well.
But they haven't traced Brent yet.
They're doing everything that they can.
It's everything that they know.
Brent is using a cell phone, okay? Every time he calls, he changes the number. It's impossible to trace.
Well, Michael, I know our team at Spaulding is good. I hired every one of them, but they're not even in the same league as this guy. Lucy's life is on the line. She needs the best. Let me call this man. He
you
can advise
it,
us.
Forget it, all right? What? Forget it. When my people say that there's nothing more that can be done, I believe them.
Hello, Michael?
Of course you are. Isn't Lucy lovely this evening? I know you've always thought so, but especially tonight, don't you think? You're probably wondering, why does she look so divine? It's quite simple, really. She dressed for me tonight. The tape on the mouth was my idea, of course. She has such a pretty mouth. Got a little noisy around here just a little while ago, so I had to make her wear it, but I promise I will take it off just before I kiss her. Too bad you can't be here. Hey, maybe you can be. Maybe I can get you a ticket for the show, ticket for one, best seat in the house. The curtain could be going up very soon, Al Michael. Very, very soon.
Clary, perfect timing. Thank you.
This is as good as it gets. It's all queued up, ready to go.
All right, this was recorded Monday, November 13th, 7:05 p.m. If this is Roger's voice, it doesn't prove who took the money. only that he was the one that ratted on Marcus Williams. Do you understand that?
Yes, I do. Yes, I do. Okay. Except that Roger did everything, believe me. He's the one who stole the cash from Hampton's cash drawer. He's the one who planted it in Marcus' saxophone case. And he's also the one who phoned in his phony tip to you guys at the police here to frame Marcus.
Yeah, but when Hamp hears the tape, he's going to know what we know. He will drop the theft charges. He's got to.
There goes.
I'm telling you, Marcus Williams is the guy who stole the money from the tower's cash register. I saw him with my own two eyes.
Holly, is that Roger?
It could be.
We really need you to be sure.
He's always using phony accents like that. I can't say 100% sure. You?
You know, as much as I'd like to say that is him, but no, I can't be sure either.
All right, let's help them with whatever they need, okay? I'm going to go down to the computer store, see if I missed anything.
Sure.
Thanks, you guys.
Yeah, sure. Thank you. Listen, will you play it one more time, Claire?
Yeah.
I'm telling you, Marcus Williams is the guy who stole the money from the tower's cash register. I saw him with my own two eyes.
Well, if it isn't the Harmonious Tunes, a dear old dad.
A Marion Crane file. Eureka.
Abigail, I've been thinking.
Right.
We need to talk about what happened here.
Oh, it's okay? No, Abby, it's not okay, okay? We need to talk, all right? I don't want any misunderstanding, confusion. Abby, I need you to trust me, all right? It's best for our friendship, you know, that we talk about this now. No, it's not your mistake. I did this. I set this whole thing up because I thought there was a boy in your ASL class that you had a crush on. This is not about a boy in your class, right?
Life ruined. Over and done with. Yes, I saw Jay. That's the problem.
Who's this guy, Jay?
I dropped him off at the mall, and now I feel like a fool.
Michelle, you need to start talking to your big brother here. What's going on?
No, we went out. It could have been great, fabulous even, but I blew it. I must have given him the wrong signals, and now Jay thinks that I'm a big, fat baby.
Michelle, did this guy make a pass at you?
More like a fumble.
Michelle, you need to tell me if this guy put his hands on you where you didn't want them to go. Say yes or no.
Yeah. Rick, no.
Where is this guy?
No, Rick.
All right, I am here. What is so important to you? I'm not exactly a VIP in this place.
Well, you will be soon.
Yeah, right, and I'm Hamp's employee of the month.
Listen to me. By the time Roger and I are through, Hamp Speaks is going to be giving you the same royal treatment that he gives your father.
Oh, that's just great. This is super. What, did he put you up to this?
No, of course not. Now knock it off. Take the chip on your shoulder, check it at the door, and help me pick out a fabulous champagne. Like the one we had in Morocco. Remember Morocco?
I remember everything about Morocco up until the third bottle. What is the good news, Diamond?
Okay. You've been patient. You've been good. I'll tell you. There's good news. There's great news.
Okay.
First of all, Roger is going to reveal the real suspect in Cutter's murder on WSPR.
What?
And then, after you're cleared of the murder charges, he's going to get the theft charges dropped, too.
Dinah, you're kidding me.
No, and the stupid police, and it's going to be so embarrassing for them, I can't wait. I mean, think about it. A private citizen having to right the scales of justice?
Are you serious? He's going to air with this?
Yeah, it would probably make the 7 o'clock news.
How much does he know? Tell me everything he knows and who he told it to, Dinah. Leave this.
Marcus, somehow I thought you'd be taking this better.
I hope he didn't injure himself in his zeal to return my greeting.
Well, he probably didn't want to draw a lot of attention to himself.
Well, I'm not blaming him. He just gave me back the same kind of warmth I gave him over the years. You know, it took me way too long to realize that a kid needs more than 3 squares a day, a roof over his head, and a cause to believe in.
Don't be so quick to sell all of that short, Griffin.
Marcus does. He's right. Now that I have a clue about being a father, it may be too late.
Now, I think that Marcus cares about you a lot more than you realize.
Well, I wish that were true. Look, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. We were talking about Roger Thorpe. Listen, Jelly, I know you work for the man, but he's put my son through hell, and I need to know why.
Oh, believe me, it is not a part of my job description to keep my boss's name out of the mud. As far as Marcus and Roger are concerned, I think it's pretty cut and dry. Marcus is a very close friend of Dinah's, and Roger never approved.
For that, he found it necessary to frame my son on a robbery charge? I mean, couldn't you have just said, find another friend?
Well, maybe he did, and she wouldn't.
Roger's methods of control are, to say the least, extreme. Not to mention completely illegal.
I'm sorry, but that describes Roger to a T. He'll run over anybody to get what he wants. You know, some people in this town think that the only reason that he married Dinah was to get her family's goat.
If that's true, this man should be put away.
I'm sorry, but it appears one of our players isn't feeling well this evening, and we all know I'm too much of a gentleman to force myself on the lady.
Oh, I'll show you what force really is. We'll get this guy out of Michael, I promise you. Before he hurts Lucy, I'll use every resource I have and more.
He will not get away with this. We'll find him wherever
he is.
You're
a dead man, Brent.
Oh, shucks! We're out of time. Tick-tock, tick-tock, tick-tock. Well, if Lucy's feeling more romantically inclined, I'll get in touch. TTFN, ta-ta for now.
Sweetheart, I have a couple errands to run. Be an angel and wait here for me to get back.
Don't worry. I'm not going after Alan Michael. That would spoil the plan. Why bother to go out when I can wait right here for him to deliver himself? Ding dong. Spaulding calling. This is gonna be delicious.
I'll see what it is. Roger Thorpe, what are you doing here?
Helping out one of my news reporters.
What do you want?
I was told you could fill me in on Marion Crane.
The press conference was canceled.
That's why I'm here.
Get out now. We have a matter of life or death on our hands. There is no time and no information for the press. Do I make myself clear?
Oh, absolutely. Clear? No problem. I will let myself out.
I'll die of total humiliation. Nothing happened.
I don't want to come
already.
Off like Dad, but I am your big brother.
No, wait a minute. You know, first relationships mean a lot, okay? You know, it's good that you had this first relationship because the experience is good for you.
But if this guy touched you, I want to know about it.
Okay, it's my fault I let him on.
Oh, did he tell you to say that so you'd put
no.
out because
no,
you
no,
did,
no,
I put
no.
in a
I
small
did it and
box.
I said it, okay? Can we just drop it, please?
All right, only if you never do this again, because boys have got the self-control of rabbits.
Look, I can handle this. You told me I need experience, and you're right, so let me handle it my way, okay?
Okay, so do it, okay?
Okay!
Okay! It's okay.
I'm sorry, I know. You're trying to be a big brother, and I shouldn't have jumped down your throat.
Yeah, heels and all.
Can I make it up to you with a movie? There's a great one on TV tonight.
Not only if you make the popcorn.
Deal.
All right. I'll be right back. I'm gonna buy some popcorn.
You know, I love my big brother, but sometimes he's a little crazy. Jay, what happened with Jay? How do I say this? I
Blew it. Me. I blew it. You don't understand. I mean, I blew it. Okay, I made a big mistake. Explain. All right? There we were, alone. Me and this really hot guy. And I did everything wrong. And now he thinks I'm a total geek. You blew it too. Girl, this man-woman thing is a lot harder than on TV.
A hell of a coincidence.
I was looking for you two. The people down at the Journal said I may be able to find you down here.
Is that right? What can we do you out of?
Well, it seems as if my father's giving Diana a hard time. And I, you know, she's a nice girl, and I just, you know, it keeps filling her head with one line after another, one lie after the other.
Old news. Yeah. Standard operating procedure for your father.
What makes you think that this voice you hear in this tape is your father's?
Sounds a lot like him.
Could it be somebody else?
It could be.
Well, we could make a voice print of this and then compare it to another tape of Roger's.
That would be the only way we can be 100% sure.
Right. Do you have any? Maybe an old answering machine tape, home video?
I don't know. Can we just get one somehow? Can we get somebody to do that?
Yeah, could the department help us?
Well, see, that's the problem. Absolutely all of our manpower right now is out looking for Lucy. I don't know when we could assign someone to tape Roger.
Well, then, could we do it? Could we just wire somebody, get them to record Roger, come back here with the tape?
I guess so. There's a spy store down on 3rd Street, sells surveillance equipment. I could talk to the guys at the lab. They can run the voice print and...
How soon can we get this?
Right away. But who do we get to wear the wire?
Me!
Could it be that Thorpe considers my son to be a threat to his marriage? I mean, Marcus is an extremely charming young man.
Yes, he is.
He's handsome, intelligent, he's talented. Why are you looking at me like that?
After all the times that Marcus has rejected you, you still think he's great, don't you?
I'm very proud of him. It's too bad he doesn't know it.
Well, maybe he will someday. You know, the whole thing that's ridiculous about this whole setup is, according to David, Marcus and Dinah never really shared anything more than a friendship. So Marcus was never that kind of a threat to Roger.
Well, what if Dinah's not the friend that Marcus thinks she is? What if she's in cahoots with her old man?
Dinah may be a first-rate bimbo for having married the man, but from all I can see, she really cares for your son. If I were to bet, the problem is Roger and Roger alone.
How unfortunate for Mr. Thorpe. He picked the wrong man to mess with. And I don't mean Marcus.
Wait a minute. You knew about the other suspect?
I've known him for a few days, man.
But Marcus, why didn't you tell my father? You can get the murder charges dismissed now. What are you thinking?
I was thinking about Lucy Cooper in the hands of a psychotic killer, Dinah. Everyone that knows about this, including the press, has agreed to keep it a secret. They figure it's the only way right now of keeping Lucy alive. If Brent Loris finds out that people know, he'll kill her.
I didn't know about this. And I know that Roger didn't know about this either. Oh, my God. What if Roger found out already? I mean, what if he puts it on the news tonight?
Dinah, you have to find him. Find him and stop him before he screws up everything.
Call me immediately. This is an emergency. else to try.
Dinah, think of something.
Excellent. Full house as it should be. Ladies and gentlemen, if I might direct your attention to the 7 o'clock evening news. Max, could you turn on WSPR, please?
Sure, Mr. Thorpe.
Thank you. Now, as some of you may know, I have been widely accused of framing my wife's dear friend, Marcus Williams. I think that what you are about to see will put those lies to rest. Pump up the volume, Max.
A WSPR I-Team exclusive. It seems that the murder of Detective Patrick Cutter is anything but an open and shut case. I-Team has learned the real reason the accused killer, Marcus Williams, was granted bail several days ago. There's been a bizarre break in the case, which indicates there is a new suspect in the killing. One Marion Crane, also known as Brent Lawrence. Disguised as a woman, Lawrence apparently stalked the veteran police detective for several months.
One right, the movie's about to start.
Exclusive eye sources revealed late today that Brent Lawrence, fired from Spaulding Enterprises last summer for misconduct and believed to be dead, was actually rehired 5 months ago as this woman, Marion Crane. Although the motive for the murder of Detective Cutter remains unclear at this hour.
What is
the
it?
I-Team will continue to keep you updated on this breaking story.
Tell me.
Get it.
Spaulding. Yes, Alexandra. Whoa, just slow down. All right, thank you.
And Alex.
She wants us to watch the news, WSPR.
WSPR's exclusive Eye on Springfield coverage of Brent Lawrence's deadly masquerade as a woman named Marion Crane continues with an in-depth special following this newscast.
Yeah, right.
It's him! It's you!